So if I move two fighters, I can win planet 4 and still tie at planet 3.
Uh-huh.
Hey! How's the new mech game?
Well, I thought the limited scope would be an issue, but it has surprising strategic depth. And the balance is fine at the two-player level. But what's really interesting is that it can be seen as a deconstruction of the area control genre. Now, Nitzi and his contemporaries might disagree, but I think there's a valid point there.
You know what this game needs? Color-coded bases for the mech units. It's hard to tell whose is whose.
Is it fun?
I don't understand the question.
Guys! You'll never guess what I found! I thought I lost it ages ago, but it turns out I've had it all along!
Your virginity?
Ha!
Close! Does anyone remember? HeroQuest?
Whoa! Where'd you dig up that old thing?
Wait, is this the game we used to play back in grade school?
Yeah! Remember all the awesome times we had?
I mostly remember that old commercial where the kid turns into an orc.
Oh, we're gonna turn into orcs?
Maybe! Who wants to play?
Ooh, me! Yeah.
Okay, it looks like all the components are accounted for. Except for this gargoyle with no face, and an orc that's clearly been microwaved.
Hey, look! Our old character sheets!
Oh man, this brings me back.
Who is the dwarf?
I don't remember. What's the name?
Dildo Daggins.
George.
Then you must have been.
Phineas Faircock. I remember you.
Man, this is like opening up a time capsule from fourth grade.
I know, right?
Isn't it amazing how much we've grown up since then?
What should we do? Start with the first scenario?
Yeah, I could use a refresher.
Whoa! These are my notes for the custom campaign I was running for you guys.
Oh yeah, whatever happened to that?
All enemies are invisible. Traps are not disarmable.
I'm starting to remember why we stopped playing this with you.
Guys, we could finish it. Think about it. Time has been frozen in this world for 25 years. We could pick up right back where we left off and finally complete the campaign we left undone as kids. An epic adventure, 25 years in the making.
Let's do it.
For 25 years, the land of Radland has been under an iron rule. But now, its legendary heroes of yore have once again awakened to confront the great evil and defeat God Emperor Ass Lord.
That's what you called him?
It sounded a lot cooler when I was a kid.
Looks like Ass Lard to me.
It's Ass Lord.
Alright, let's do it. Dwarf, barbarian, you ready to team up again against the ultimate evil?
Hell yeah.
On guard, Ass Lard.
Of ambivalence has been broken. We're free again.
What? How long has it been? And what's happened to Radland?
That foul magic has trapped us for years. Our quest has failed and our world is lost.
Calm yourself, Oaf.
There may yet be way to restore peace to these lands. Though our sleep was long, the God Emperor must have become complacent in our absence and has likely forgotten many nuances of this world and its finicky rules. If we strike now, we may yet take him by surprise.
Aye, leave the morning to the lasses. We must continue our quest.
Onward, to Aslord Castle!
For Radland!
Does anyone remember how to move?
Oh, I think you need these.
Dice. How quaint.
God, roll to move?
I remember that. From fucking Candyland.
Okay, yeah, it's a little outdated, but come on, the game's 20 years old. It's bound to have some rusty mechanics.
No kidding. Do we also attack by flicking marbles into hippos' mouths?
Okay, look, so anyway, you guys enter the dungeon here. Now, as you go around and explore, you'll find secret doors, hidden passageways, and dead ends, and eventually learn the layout of the land. Your ultimate goal is to find God Emperor Asslord and defeat him. Now, ready.
Who's that?
God Emperor Asslord, mightiest wizard in the realm.
If he's so great, then why is he looking in his book to cast?
Yeah, memorize your spells, you lazy fuck.
Well, see, he only actually got an associate's in wizardry. All the tests at Wizard Community College were open book.
Okay, you know what? God Emperor Asslord will remember this insolence when he's thinking of your punishments later.
Okay, what can we do?
Okay, you get one action. You can attack, cast a spell, search for treasure, search for secret doors, or search for traps.
Okay, sounds like searching is important then. I'll search for traps.
Okay. You find nothing.
Okay, I'll search for secret doors.
All right. You find nothing.
I'll search for treasure.
You find, oh, a card from the treasure deck.
Ooh.
Nothing? We have to print this on a card?
Well, you know, guys, maybe the real treasure is realizing what a fucking waste of time searching is. I mean, seriously? Can't you throw us a bone here? I'm at this huge rack.
I mean, I wouldn't say it's huge. You have gained some weight.
This rack, moron!
Oh, that. No, that's nothing. It's just the thing.
What does it do?
I don't know. It looks sweet. What does that do?
That holds stuff.
Fuck you, okay? It's just, it's decoration or whatever.
Nice world building, ass lad.
Ass lord! Lord! Ass lord!
Okay, you know what? Let's just get out of here.
Way ahead of you. I rolled a 10 to move. Let's open that door and I'll move out into the hallway.
Ah, son of a loon!
Yeah, I don't think those are supposed to be functional.
So why even have them?
Not everything needs a purpose. Sometimes you just have stupid shit for decoration. Like, why do we have Hannah?
Hmm?
Or Brandon?
Does anyone have a knife?
Okay, fine. Just, can we go through the stupid door already?
Okay. So, you poke your head through the door, and see this.
Ooh, baddies. All right, I'll stab him with my short sword.
Okay, roll 2d6, skulls or hits.
Two.
Nice, I roll one defense, dead.
Yeah, killed him. What do I get?
Let me guess,
nothing.
No loot or XP?
Nope.
Fuck this game.
Ah! What's wrong?
My leg. I can't move it. The curse of ambivalence returns. We must find and destroy the God Emperor quickly before I get
bored and give up.
Okay, let's spread out to cover more ground. I'll go down this corridor, you two split up and go that way. On it. Call out if you find the boss.
Wait, what's the code word?
What code word?
Well, we need a code word. Otherwise the monsters will be like, help me, and you'll run into a trap.
Hey, that's really smart, Brandon.
Thanks. Now, what's a good code word?
Oh, how about twinkadoo twinkadoo, bolly cup Butterfield.
I'm going.
Okay, don't forget the code word.
Thank you. All right, you know what?
Thou must up it thy game if thou wishest to trap me. Forsooth.
Maybe you should look before you leap.
Really? Two adjacent traps?
Not just two adjacent traps, but putting the second one just around the corner out of line of sight so you couldn't detect it.
So if the second one was going to get me no matter what, then wasn't the first one a complete waste?
Roll for spike damage.
Oh, hey, it's you. What are you doing back here?
Kiting mobs.
Me too.
Hey, wait. There's only two doors in this room. You go block that one, I'll block this one, and they'll all be stuck out in the hallway.
I don't think splitting up was such a good idea. We aggroed like half the dungeon at once. Guess that's the other half. Should we go help?
That's not the code word.
Well, George has found God Emperor Asslord.
Come help me, you fucks!
Can't. We're trapped.
Yeah, we've got all the enemy mobs piled up in the hallway. We can't move past them.
So kill them!
Nope.
No can do. That'll unplug the bottleneck. We have a very finely tuned ecosystem here of not getting our asses kicked. You're on your own.
So, how do I want to do this?
Let me just get something from the hall.
I back up.
You know there's no escape, right? You have to roll for movement each round. I get an automatic 8.
You don't say.
Fine. I pursue. And this goblin attacks Brandon, and this one attacks Hana for nothing and 1.
I defend it.
Well, I'll deal with you guys personally just as soon as I'm done with going at the barbarian over here. All right. Brandon, your move.
We do. No point in attacking. It just makes room for another one.
Oh, I know. I search for treasure.
Nope. Says here that you cannot perform a search if any monsters are visible to you.
Okay, well, I take my sword and I gouge my eyes out. Then I search for treasure. Ha! Beat your stupid system.
I did not expect that.
Hey, look! 35 gold!
The fuck? Are you okay?
George had a healing potion on him. I'll make him trade it to me later.
Can you do that?
The rules are kind of iffy on that.
This fucking game.
I back up.
My minions and I advance on you. Your cowardice only serving to whet their appetite.
Oh, so you're blocking the doorway now, right? What was that you said? Look before you leap? Let's see. Oh, my battle axe gives me 4 attack dice.
4?
So, ready to get torn a new ass, Lord?
No? shoot. Do I have something in here? I teleport away! So long, suckers!
What does that do?
It says it lets him instantly escape to a predetermined safe room.
Yeah, enjoy spending the next 20 minutes searching for me again as I summon more minions.
Hi! Fancy meeting you here. Hey, you teleported right into the same room as us.
I see that.
Well, that's convenient.
Okay, I'm coming. Just hold them off till I get there.
Well, guess this epic battle starts now.
I attack with my dagger.
Miss.
Use a spell or something.
I already used up all my spells. I only get the 3.
You're caster class and you only get 3 spells for the whole dungeon? What is up with this game?
What is it?
My sword arm.
Curse of ambivalence. We haven't got much time before we become completely disillusioned with this clunky game. Hurry, George! I dash down the hallway.
Can I move diagonally?
No, I don't think so.
Esther.
Ha! A hit! 1 damage.
Defended.
Oh.
2 to attack. Nothing.
Are you almost here yet?
34 spaces left. 3.
Oh my god.
Hana man!
My legs have turned gray!
Is there even a point in attacking? I'm rolling with 1 and you get 5 defense.
I don't know.
Hey! Where are you going?
I've lost interest.
Yeah, me too.
It's just too clunky. Rolling to move is lame. Not getting rewards or XP for killing monsters is lame. Spending 10 turns trying to catch up with the party when they're on the other side of the map is terrible. I mean, modern games just do these mechanics so much better.
I guess once you go Amera trash, you can't go Amera back.
Hmm.
So why did we like this game so much? Like, were we just stupid?
No, we were kids. Back then there was nothing else like this. It was just chutes and ladders or fucking Monopoly. Now there's tons of great games. HeroQuest didn't change. We did.
The world did. Remember that time we were fighting a bunch of orcs and George was stuck in the other room with all the zombies?
Oh, yeah. And you kept making them chase you around the central pillar like 5 or 6 times because they couldn't match your move speed.
Yeah, stupid slow-ass zombies.
Oh, how about the teleporting place where every door led to another random place in the dungeon?
Oh my god!
I love that one!
Yeah, and I drew that whole map trying to piece together the logic of it all.
Yeah, until you realized I was just making it up as I went along.
What an asshat.
Wait a minute, come on. This game has to be good, right? I mean, like, we're sitting here reminiscing about shit that happened 20 years ago. There has to be something to that.
Should we give it another try?
Yeah. Yes. But this time, let's just turn off the analytical parts of our brain and just have fun.
How do we do that? We're not kids anymore.
I've got it.
You're a genius.
I have my moments.
Okay, 1 more shot.
Wait. If we're gonna do this, we should do it right. Help me with the table.
Broadsword! Fire him! Rock! Oh! You found the melting trap!
The what?
Roll for radiation damage.
Whoa, me!
Yeah, I call DM next game. Give me the rulebook.